Welcome back to Bavarian RC. Today's video is, hey, wait a minute, come a little closer. Much closer. Yeah, that's okay. So today's video is all about this little guy, the GPS Logger 3 from SM-Modellbau, and how I modified it to be used in a standalone mode, and some more stuff, you'll see. This GPS Logger is a very powerful piece of equipment. For example, it allows you to view your complete flight in Google Earth. It lets you analyze things like altitude profiles, distance from start, or speed profiles. Or gives you key elements of your flight, like date, start and landing time, duration, maximum speed, average speed, maximum altitude, total flight distance, cumulative height, average and max climb rate, same for the sink rate, or the max and min g-forces in all three axes. The data can be downloaded from the micro SD card either as a KMZ file for Google Earth or as a CSV file to be used in Excel for further analysis. There's really tons of data that allows you to analyze many aspects of your flight. It's really a must-have tool for me. The GPS Logger 3 comes with a cable to hook it up directly to the telemetry channel of your receiver, a micro SD adapter, and a USB card reader. The logger is quite small and weighs only 11 grams. On the upper side, you can find the GPS module. On the bottom, it has a micro SD card, which automatically records all the data once it is powered up and a proper position has been determined. Optionally, you can also connect a tech sensor for measuring the true airspeed. The COM port is for connecting either a display, a Unilog sensor, or for updating the firmware. The link connector is for telemetry and power supply, connected via this cable to the receiver. For more info, check out the manufacturer's website. I'll put the link in the description below. In most of the cases, you would want to connect the logger directly to the telemetry channel of your receiver, like in this example with my triple Neo. Nevertheless, I sometimes found that I would need to use it in a standalone mode. One example is my twin turbo Lidl, which is a hopelessly nose-heavy design. Positioning the logger at the tail would help a lot for balancing. But running cables along the whole fuselage wouldn't be a very nice solution. As the logger is storing all of the data on the micro SD card, a standalone solution shouldn't be a problem. So this is what I came up with. I designed a small 3D printed case, connected the logger to a 1-cell LiPo battery, and then strapped it to the tail of my twin turbo. Having this weight at the tail, it balances quite easily. As I don't fully trust the Velcro tape, I added another Velcro strap around the case. With its small cross-section and a height of only 15 mm, the aerodynamic drag is not penalizing the flight performance too much. The case has a length of 87 mm and a width of 29. The total weight is 37 grams, whereas the case accounts for 11 grams and the battery for 15 grams. Let's not forget the cable with 1 gram and the logger with 11 grams. I will now show you in detail how to build the standalone modification of the SM GPS Logger 3. A list of all the used material and a link to the free STL files for the 3D printed case are in the description below. Now let's start the build. Thank you. The power consumption of the GPS logger is around 60 milliamp hours in full operation. So this 600 milliamp hour battery will give you about 2 to 3 hours of runtime before the voltage drops too low. If you want to be on the safe side, just use a second battery as a backup. When installing the logger, make sure the side with the triangle is facing forward to get a correct allocation of the G-forces to the respective axis. To charge the small one-cell LiPo battery, I'm using my normal LiPo charger. You can either make a special charging cable using banana plugs and a JST-XH connector, or if you don't want to swap all the time between cables, simply make an adapter from XT60 to the JST-XH connector. By the way, if you wonder what this is my self-designed LiPo safe. Check out the link in the description below or in the upper right corner if you want to see my build video. Even if you use your logger directly connected to the telemetry of your receiver, a small case can be quite helpful. Therefore, I designed this little case. I hope you liked my video. If yes, please consider subscribing and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching Bavarian RC.